We say you accept us this morning, Lord, and accept our worship in your presence. Brethren, let's just rise up on our feet and begin to worship God this morning. If you know that you are created for him and for him alone, this morning just lift up your hands and just worship your maker. Father, we just worship you this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Therefore, brethren, present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable, because that is your reasonable act of worship. Amen. Hallelujah. I will give you all my worship. Together.
our life.
That's why we can face tomorrow. Father, we just worship you, Jesus. We just want to worship you again this morning. Because you're here with us. Thank you, Emmanuel.
Let Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised.
You are Alpha.
You are Alpha and Omega.
Give him glory this morning. Give him honor that is due to his name. Just worship. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, is the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. Just worship him. Give him praise. Yes, we thank you. We worship you, Lord. We bless you. For another prayer in your presence like this, we worship. Blessed be the holy name. Amen. 2 Kings chapter 2 from 23 to 24. He said, he went up from Jericho to Bethel. On the way, young man, sure and accountable boys came out of the city and mocked him and said to him, go up in a wide wheel, you bowed head. Go up, you bowed head. And he turned around and looked at them and call a curse down on them in the name of the Lord. And the two she-bears came out of the wood and ripped up the 42 of the boys. I want you to pray this morning. Whatsoever is mocking you, that God will curse them. You know, anything that said, where's your God? You see, Elijah, yeah, Elisha. I'm not talking about human being now. So whatsoever that does not want you to become enlarged, you will curse them this morning. Whatsoever that want to hinder you from become enlarged, where God wants you to be, I want you to curse them this morning. You see, Jesus, he cursed that fig tree. He cursed it. And I want you to call upon the name of the Lord. If I say any tree that my father did not plant, it shall be uprooted. Yes. Ask the Lord to curse everything hindering you for reaching your goal. For just walk in your purpose, in the destiny that God has created you. I want you to open your mouth and curse them this morning. Just curse them in the name of the Lord. Whatsoever is standing on your way of enlightenment, whatsoever is standing on your way of your purpose in life, curse them this morning. Curse them this morning in the name of Jesus. Failure, barrenness, whatsoever it is, Oh Jesus, I curse everything standing me on my way to your purpose in my life. In the name of Jesus, whatsoever is mocking me, Lord Jesus, this morning, I curse them in the name of Jesus. I curse them in the name of Jesus. Anything mocking my children, anything mocking my wife, anything mocking my marriage, anything mocking my business, Jesus, curse them this morning. Anything mocking my ministry, Jesus, curse them this morning in the name of Jesus. Yes, I curse them, Lord. Yes, curse them in the name of Jesus. Yes, serving the God of miracle.
I know. Yes, I know. I'm serving the God of miracles. I know, yes, I know.
Hallelujah.
I am serving the God of miracles. I know.
To pray now. Bible says goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I want you to personalize it at Opeoluwa Ayobanile, Alice Ayobanile. Goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Progress, increase, enlargement. I want you to open your mouth. You need to verbalize it this morning. Whatsoever you desire, Lord, ask the Lord this morning. Father, in the name of Jesus, Opeoluwa and Alice Ayobanile, goodness and mercy shall follow you. Progress shall follow you. Increase, increase, increase. Enlargement, Lord. Yes, I will be there and not the tail. In the name of Jesus. That is what your word said to me. The Lord, you will enlarge my course. In the name of Jesus. That I will not be weak. You will strengthen me. You will empower me. You will enlarge me, Lord. In the name of Jesus, because you are my God and you are a big God. Nothing you cannot do. There's nothing impossible with you. Jesus, enlarge me, enlarge my household, enlarge my ministry, enlarge my children, enlarge my home. In the name of Jesus, prosper me. In the name of Jesus, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. We thank you, Jesus. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You are here this morning. You are heartbroken. I want you to be sure that today, as you hear the word of God, God will lift that broken up. In the Bible says, it's the lifter of our head. I don't know what that issue it is. But as you press him this morning, as you have worshiped him this morning, and as the word will come out, Bible says he sent his word, and his word healed them and delivered them from all their destructions. Be assured that, Lord, you are in the right place this morning, that God will totally, completely deliver you. He will restore your broken hearted. Father, we thank you this morning. We give you praise. Bible says, in your presence there's a fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasure forevermore. Do that which you can do today, Lord. In the life of your children. Touch life, save, Lord. Deliver, set free, Lord. Let us know our purpose in life. And we'll run with it. We thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Good morning, church. I would like to use this opportunity to welcome all our guests to RCCG Living Spring Harrisburg this morning. Please rise up. Any guest? Okay. You'll be given the mic. Please tell us your name. Who invited you and where you are coming from?
Good morning, everybody. Yeah, my name is Napoleon Victor. I was invited by Dr. Festus.
Welcome. The ushers will be giving you a visitor's card. Please fill it out and drop it in the offering bowl during offering. And also, Pastor would like to share a word of prayer with you. His room is on my right with the exit sign on top. So we are going to do our usual greetings this morning. Greet one or two people, tell them, this year is my year of enlargement. Mean it as you say it. Go back to our seats now. Please, let's go back to our seats. Thank you very much. It is time for announcements. So please, if you have, listen to the yellow leaflet. Days to remember, today, March 12, 2017, there shall be a home fellowship at 6 p.m. Please find your home fellowship leaders and host on the bulletin board. Also, all home fellowship leaders, please meet with Sister Temi Lola after service to pick up the campaign materials. This week, Monday through Friday, between 6 and 6:30 a.m., we have our weekly telephone prayers. The dial-in and the access code are listed. Wednesday, March 15 at 6 p.m., we have intercessory prayer. On the same day at 7, we have Bible study. Upcoming event, March 25th, between 4 p.m. and 8 p.m., we have class 301. March 26th, between 9 a.m. and 10:30 a.m., we have workers' meeting. April 1st, between 4 to 8, we have class 401. Nursery workers, Olympian Bible lesson teachers, and then the early breakfast, your names are listed here. Class 201 will take place on March 18th from 4 to 8 p.m. Members who have taken class 101 are encouraged to sign up for the upcoming class with Sister Taffy Nehanda. Faith into Action. Registration for Faith into Action 2017 has begun. The cost of registration before April 30th is $125 per person. For more information, please see Sister Rachel Jaka. Her number is listed. Birthdays, please ensure to call them and wish them a happy birthday. Wedding anniversary, we have the Harpers, we have the Josephs. We wish them a long-lasting union. Pledges, those who have not yet submitted their pledge, forms may drop them off in the offering bowl as it is being passed. Prayer requests, please forward all your requests to the intercessory group through Pastor Ope Ayobandeli. His number is listed. And that is the end of our announcement today. Thank you.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
God is good. How many of you are happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning? It is wonderful to be in God's house. On a day when the clock rolls forward, you have to wake up in the middle of the night. But it is good. This morning in the course of the week, there was the International Women's Day, and it's a time when we take time to appreciate the women Paul, this thing is echoing, please. We take time to appreciate the women that God has placed in our lives and who are doing great things for God. And so I want to first appreciate Pastor Yinka for being a wonderful mother for the house. And I want to appreciate Sister Jana, the women's president. God has been good. I'm going to now call on all the women 18 and above to please just come forward and let's appreciate them, let's pray for them. 21 and above, age 21 and above. They say the 18 are still young. Okay. 21 and above, please come forward. You guys are singing.
This is
what are you
who we are in you, a voice made for the praise of you. Every color, tongue, and tribe crying out to the King.
This is who we are in you,
a voice
made for the praise of you.
Every color,
tongue, and tribe
crying out to the King.
Are in their house for that which God is using them to do in His kingdom. Amen. It is not a small thing that God is doing, and we really appreciate you. And the Lord Almighty God Himself will continue to watch over you. Amen. And continue to bless all that pertains to you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Men, can you just rise up and stretch your hands and pray for the women? In Jesus' name. Father, Lord, we thank you for your children. We thank you, Lord, because you brought them into this world for great purposes. We thank you for how far you've used them in their families, in their workplaces, in your kingdom. We ask, Lord, that you accept our thanks in Jesus' name. We pray, Lord, that you continue to make your face to shine upon your children Continue to bless and prosper them. Lord, whatever they lay their hands upon shall prosper according to your will in Jesus' name. Amen. We pray, Lord, that you will renew their strength, you renew their energy, you renew their vision. Father, Lord, for those who are wives, Father, Lord, continue to bless them in that office. For those who are mothers, Father, Lord, continue to bless them and continue to give them wisdom that they need. For those who are looking unto you for the fruit of the womb, Father, Lord, we pray, Lord, that you grant them to them children from on high in Jesus' name. For those who are among them that are looking forward to be married, Father, Lord, in the fullness of time, Father, Lord, bone of their bone, flesh of their flesh, you bring into their lives and you bind them together. We just thank you, Father, for that which you are doing in the lives of all your children in this church, all the women in this church, and we pray, Lord, that you continue to glorify yourself in their lives. Thank you, Father, Lord, because you have done all this. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Music. There is ice cream for Sister Tony's birthday was this week. She has ice cream for you after service for everybody.
Stand for our congregational hymn. Children, you can leave for your classes after the first verse. The title of the hymn is To God Be the Glory. Amen. Ooh.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
To God be the glory for all the things he has done. And he has done great, great things. Amen. It's time for our tithes and the giving of our offerings. I'll ask that if you'd like an envelope for the giving of your tithe, please raise your hand, keep your hand raised, and I shall get to you in time. Those of us who are giving by check, please make your check out to RCCG Living Spring. RCCG Living Spring for those of us who are making out our checks this morning. For our visitors, you're given some visitors form. Please include it as the plate is passed. Just drop it in the offering plate this morning. Amen.
Amen.
All right, let me just read. I'll jump around. This is from 1 Chronicles, just to encourage us in our giving this morning. First Chronicles 29 says, and David the king said to all the assembly, Solomon my son, whom alone God has chosen, is young and inexperienced, and the work is great for the palace, will not be for man, but will be for the Lord. So I have provided for the house of my God so far as I'm able. And then he talks about the gold and the silver, the bronze, and everything that he's going to give. Let's jump down to verse 5. Who then will offer willingly, consecrating himself today to the Lord? Amen?
Amen.
Offer willingly, consecrating yourself to the Lord. Let me just invite the ushers, please. Let us bless the offering this morning. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the privilege of giving our tithes and our offerings this morning. Lord, we are offering them willingly. We're offering them joyously. We're offering them cheerfully. And Lord, we are consecrating ourselves to you. Father, may everything, every offering that is given in this place be acceptable. Accept it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Goodbye to my pain. Mm-hmm. And my sorrow. So long. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Let us thank the Lord. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for you have delivered us. You have delivered us. You, the miracle working God. Father, receive the offerings this morning. Lord, may you add your blessing to it. For it is your blessing that makes rich and adds no sorrow to it. Lord, to the people who have given, Lord, they are living blessed. They are living pain-free, yes, to increase and to expand. Yes. Lord, this offering, as we offer it to you and your kingdom, Lord, it is increasing, it is expanding. Amen. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.